Aladdin and the Magic Lamp. Once upon a time, there was a boy named Aladdin. He lived with his mother in the desert of Arabia. His father had passed away due to illness. They were very poor. Aladdin was a lazy boy who just used to eat, sleep, and roam around in the village throughout the day. His mother used to work in other people's house for a living. Aladdin's mother was tired of Aladdin's behavior. Every day, she used to pray to God and hope for Aladdin's good behavior. Aladdin was lazy, but his soul was pure. He was kind-hearted. One day, a stranger came to their house. He was a cruel magician. He said to Aladdin's mother, "I am your husband's brother. I am sorry. I couldn't come earlier." He gave some gold coins to her. "I am a rich man and I want to help my brother's son. I live in a town far away from here. I want someone to help me with my business. If you don't mind, I would like to take Aladdin with me." Aladdin's mother trusted him. She called Aladdin and said, "Aladdin, you go with your uncle. He's a good man." With his mother's blessings, Aladdin started his journey with his uncle. They traveled on a camel for many days in the desert. Finally, they reached a quiet place surrounded by mountains and caves. "There is no one around here, Uncle. What are we doing here?" They went near a stone. Uncle chanted a spell and the stone moved automatically. There were steps to go down the cave. Uncle gave Aladdin a ring to wear and said, "It will protect you." He asked him to climb down the steps and get the old lamp and other valuables. "Uncle, why don't you come down with me? It's a holy place. Only a person with pure soul is allowed to go there." When Aladdin went down the cave, he was surprised. He saw pots of gold coins, diamonds, jewels, and precious stones. He also found the old lamp which was kept in one corner of the cave. He was surprised. "Why does Uncle want this old rusted lamp?" Aladdin gathered some gold coins, diamonds, jewels, and precious stones and kept them in a sack. He kept the lamp in his pocket. When he reached the top of the stairs, he asked his uncle to help so that he can come out of the cave. The magician said, "Give me the lamp first." Aladdin stubbornly refused. The magician got angry and he closed the mouth of the cave with his spell. Poor Aladdin was stuck inside. He shouted for help, but nobody could hear him. He was very scared and he started crying. "My mother will never know where I am." He started praying. "If God will get me out of here, I will work hard and even help my mother." Suddenly, he remembered about the ring his uncle had given him. He touched the ring and wished to see his mother. Very next moment, he was out of the cave, sitting in his home. His mother was surprised to see him. Aladdin told her about the fraud magician who pretended to be his uncle. Aladdin showed the old lamp to his mother. His mother said, clean this lamp and sell it in the market so that we can buy some food. Aladdin started to clean the lamp. As soon as he rubbed the lamp, a genie appeared. Aladdin was shocked to see the genie. "Who are you? What were you doing inside this lamp?"
"I am a genie. I live inside this lamp. It is my duty to serve the person who holds this lamp. So tell me, master, what is your wish?
Will you really take order from me?"
"Yes, my master."
"I am hungry. Can you get some food for me?"
"As you wish, master."
With his magic, the genie presented a variety of food. The plates, bowl, spoons and glasses, everything was of gold and silver. Aladdin and his mother were very happy. They ate their food. Now Aladdin asked the genie for new clothes. The genie presented new clothes to them. Aladdin asked for gold coins. The genie presented that too. Now Aladdin understood. Whatever they needed, they simply have to ask the genie for it. As days passed, Aladdin became a handsome young man. He also started his own business of gold and silver pots. One day, when he was passing by the king's palace, he saw Princess Jasmine. Aladdin immediately fell in love with the princess. He went home and said to his mother, "I want to marry Princess Jasmine. Please go and visit the king. Take some gold and diamonds for the princess." His mother visited the king and presented him a plate which was full of gold and diamonds. The king was impressed with the gift. The king said, "If your son really wishes to marry my daughter, then present me 40 more such plates full of gold and diamonds. Your son must also build a beautiful palace for my daughter." Aladdin's mother returned home and told Aladdin about the king's demands. "Mother, don't worry. Aladdin asked the genie to present a big and beautiful palace." The genie built a beautiful palace in front of King's palace. Next day, Aladdin's mother went to the palace with 40 plates of gold and diamonds. The king was very happy. He gave his daughter's hand in marriage to Aladdin. Aladdin and Princess Jasmine got married and started living happily. As the days passed, the villagers started talking about Aladdin's beautiful palace. Soon, Aladdin became very famous for building a palace overnight and marrying a princess. The cruel magician heard about this. He immediately understood that this boy must be Aladdin. Aladdin must have discovered the magical power of the lamp. The magician decided to get the lamp. He dressed himself as a lamp seller and went to Aladdin's palace. Aladdin was out of town for some work. He approached Princess Jasmine.
"Princess, if you have any old lamp, give it to me. I will give you a new shining lamp in exchange."
The princess fell into his trap. Unknowingly, she gave Aladdin's magic lamp and took a new lamp from the lamp seller. The magician immediately rubbed the lamp. The genie appeared and said,
"Tell me, master, what is your wish?"
"Take this palace along with the princess to a faraway place where nobody can find us."
"As you wish, master."
The palace disappeared along with the princess. When the king noticed that the palace has disappeared along with his daughter, He immediately called Aladdin and ordered him to find his daughter.
Aladdin was sad as he had lost his magic lamp.
Suddenly, he remembered that he still had the magic ring with him. He touched the ring and said, "Take me to my wife." Magically, he reached the place where the magician had kept Jasmine. Aladdin quietly entered the palace. He saw Jasmine crying. Aladdin gave her a bottle of sleeping medicine. He told Jasmine to mix the medicine in magician's food. Jasmine mixed the medicine in the food and gave it to the magician. The magician ate the food and fell deep asleep. Aladdin took out the lamp from magician's robe and rubbed it. The genie appeared and said, "Tell me, master, what is your wish?" Aladdin ordered the genie to take the magician far, far away and lock him up in a cave forever. The genie immediately followed his order. Aladdin again rubbed the lamp. The genie said, "Tell me, master, what is your wish?" Aladdin asked the genie to take him and Jasmine along with the palace back to the town. When the king saw the palace and his daughter back, he was very happy. They all lived happily ever after.
Hi, I'm sure you enjoyed watching this video. Please click on the subscribe button to subscribe to our channel and watch more interesting videos.